Yeah.
Tonight's show is about to begin, but before it does, I would like you very much to listen very carefully, because there are a few things you need to know. If any of you need to relieve yourselves, the toilets are yonder, over towards the Newman House, follow the path round and down the basement. There will be a 20-minute interval at which you will be able to purchase drinks and refresh yourselves. If you have brought a picnic, please enjoy. However, please take with you any rubbish, any cans, with you on your way out. Please refrain from smoking, as it will impede the act. Finally,
yeah, hello.
Please.
Yeah, we're putting any second. No.
Young man, put away that phone. Please, do not have your mobile phone switched on. Otherwise, I will take it away and crush it with my hand. Please enjoy the show. My child, thou that Lysander that has given her rise, turned her obedience which is due to me, to stubbornness and harshness, and made it so that she will not, before your grace, consent to marry with Demetrius. I beg the ancient privilege of Athens, as she is mine, I may dispose of her, which shall be either to this gentleman or to her death, according to our law, immediately provided in that case.
Hermia! Be advised, fair maid, to you, your father should be as a god, one who composed your beauty, yea, and to whom you are as but a form in wax, by him imprinted, within his power to figure or disfigure it. Demetrius is a worthy gentleman.
So is Lysander.
Well, within himself he is, but in this kind, wanting your father's voice, the other must be held the worthier.
And would my father look with my eyes?
Rather your eyes must with his judgment look.
I do entreat your grace to pardon me. I know not by what power I am made bold, nor how I may concern my modesty in such a presence here to feed my thoughts. But I beseech your grace, that I may know the worst that may befall me in this case if I refuse to wed Demetrius.
Either to die the death or to abjure forever the society of men. Therefore, fair Hermia, question your desires, where, if you yield not your father's choice, you can endure the livery of a nun, chanting cold hymns for cold, faint, fruitless moon.
So will I grow, so live, so die, my lord. captive, I will yield my virgin patent up unto his lordship, whose unwished go. My soul consents not to give sovereignty.
Take time to pause. And by the next new moon, the seeding day, betwixt my love and me, upon that day, either prepare to die for disobedience to your father's will, or else to wed Demetrius, as he would, or on Diana's altar to protest for aye austerity and single life.
Relent, sweet Hermia, and Lysander, yield thy crazed titles my certain right.
You have her father's love, Demetrius. Let me have Hermia's. Do you marry him?
Scornful Lysander! True, he hath my love, and what is mine, my love shall render him. And she is mine, and all my right unto her I do estate, unto Demetrius.
I am, my lord, as well derived as he, as well possessed, if not with vantage, as Demetrius.
I must confess that I've heard so much. But come, Aegeus, and come, Demetrius. I shall have private schooling for you both. For you, fair Hermia, look you arm yourself to fit the fancies to your father's will, or else the Lord Athens yields you up for aye austerity and single life. But Aegeus and Demetrius, I should employ you in some business against our nuptial, of something that nearly concerns yourselves.
With duty and desire, we follow you.
Admiring of his qualities. I will go tell him of Fair Hermia's flight. Then to the wood with me tomorrow night pursue her. And for this intelligence, if I have thanks, it is a dear expense. But herein mean I to enrich my pain, to have his sight thither and back again.
Play you, if it be, give it to me, I'm slow of study.
You may do it extemper, for it is nothing but roaring.
Let me play the lion, cook. I will go, that I will make any man's heart good to hear me. I will go, that I will make the Duke say, let him roar again. Let him roar again.
And you should do it, too, terribly.
You would fright the Duchess and the ladies, and that they would shriek, and that would be enough to hang us all.
That would hang us all. Every one of us all.
But I grant you, friends, if you should find the ladies out of their wits, they have no discretion but to hang us. And thus, I will aggravate my voice, so that I shall rule you as gently as any sucking cat. I shall rule you an emperor any night.
You want to play no part of Pyramus? But Pyramus is a sweet-faced man, a proper man. As one will see in a summer's stay, the most gentleman-like man. Therefore, you need play Pyramus.
Well, I will undertake it. What villain were I best to play to?
Why, what you will?
I will discharge it in any of your orange tawny beard, your purple and grain beard, your French crown colour beard, your perfect yellow.
Some of your French crowns but have no hair at all, and then you won't be barefaced. But masters, here are your parts. But masters, okay. Meet me in the palace wood, a mile without the town. For if we meet in the city, we will be dogged with company and our devices known. What else was I going to say? Sinister.
It doesn't matter. We will meet, and there we may rehearse most obscenely and courageously. Deck my ends, be perfect. Adieu!
At the Jack's off, we meet.
Enough! Hold your cup, bowstrings!
How now, spirit? Whither wander you?
Over hill, over dale, thorough bush, thorough briar, in the park, in the pale, through flood, through fire, I do wander everywhere.
Swifter than the moon's spin, and I serve the fairy queen to dew her orbs upon the green.
The cowslips call, the pensioners be, and in their gold coat spots you see. Those be ruby, fairy favours, in those freckles live their savours.
I must go seek some dewdrops here,
and hang a pearl in every cowslip's ear.
Farewell, thou long spirit, I'll be gone.
And here my queen and all her elves come anon.
The king doth keep his weapons here tonight. And take heed, the queen come not within his sight. For woe is passing venerable. Because that she, as her attendant, taketh the lovely ball who stole from the Indian king. She never had such a strange name. Jealous noble. But she, the false, withholds the lovely boy, and crowns him with flowers, and makes him all her joy. And now they never meet in Rome, but they do square.
Either I mistake your shape, or make him quite, or else you are that shrewd and knave sprite called Robin Goodfellow.
Are not you he who frights the maidens of the villagery? Skim milk, and sometimes labour in the quad.
And bootless make the breathless housewife churn, and sometimes make the drink burn no balm, misleading the others, laughing at their harm.
Those that hobgoblin call you, and sweet pup, you do their work, and they shall have good luck.
Are you not he?
Thou speakest right. Slam the May one of the night, jester open, and make him smile. And when I, a fat, bean-fed horse regard, name and likeness of a filly foal, and sometime found I in a gossip's foal, fair likeness of a most equal.
But here now comes my mistress.
I am the light of
Ariadne and a joke.
These are the forgeries of jealousy. And never since the middle summer spring, at Weird Hill, in Dale, Forest, or Mead, by Paved Fountain or by Rushy Brook. From the beach, Margaret, to the sea, dance our ringlets to the whistling wind. For with thy brawl, so hast disturbed our sport. The spring, summer, child and autumn, angry winter, has changed our haunted libraries, and in the mazed world, where the same progeny of evil comes, now not knows which is which. We, from our debate, from our dissension, we are thy parents and originals.
You amended then, the lies in you. Why should Titania cross our Oberon? I do but beg a little changeling boy to be my henchman.
Set your heart at rest. Fairyland lies not the child with me. His mother was a box of my order, and she being off of that boy, she did die. And for her sake, I do rear up her boy. And for her sake, I will not part with him.
How long within this wood intend you stay?
Perchance till after, Theseus is better. And if you will patiently dance in our round, see our moonlight revels, go with us. If not, show me, and I will spare your boy.
Give me that boy! I will go with thee.
Not for thy fairy. Fairies, away. We shall chide downright if I longer stay.
Well, go thy way. Thou shalt not from this grove till I torment thee for this injury. Puck! My gentle Puck. Come hither. Thou rememberest since once it sat upon a promontory, and heard a mermaid on a dolphin's back uttering such dulcet and harmonious breath.
I remember.
That very time I saw it, but thou couldst not flying. Between the cold moon and the earth, Cupid, all arms, certain Eglinton, a fair vessel thrown by the west, and loosed his love shaft smartly from his bow, as she pierced 100,000 hearts. Mark died with the bolt of Cupid fell, but from a little western flower, formed on white not purple. Love's wounded maidens call it love in idleness. Fetch me that flower. Herb I showed thee once, the juice of it on sleeping eyelids laid will make all man or woman mad in touch from the next live creature that it sees.
I'll put a girl round the earth in 40 minutes.
Having once this juice, I'll watch the tiny when she's asleep and drop the liquor of it in her eyes. Next, then she waking looks upon. Bull! But on meddling monkey or on busy ape, she shall pursue it with the soul of love! Who comes here? I am invisible, and I will overhear their conference.
I love thee not, therefore pursue me not. Where is Lysander and fair Hermia? The one I'll slay, the other slayeth me. Thou told me they were stolen unto this wood. Here I am, a wood within this wood. So I cannot be my Hermia. Hence, get thee gone and follow me no more.
You draw me, you hard-hearted adamant, but yet you draw not iron, but my heart is sure as steel. Leave you, you hard to draw, and I should have no power to follow you.
Do I entice you? Do I speak you fair? Or rather, do I not in plainest truth tell you I do not? I cannot love you.
And even for that, do I love you the more? I am your spaniel, and Demetrius, the more you beat me, I will fawn on you. Leave me but as your spaniel. Spurn me, strike me, neglect me, lose me. Only give me leave, and worthy as I am, to follow you. What worse a place can I beg in your love, and yet a place of high respect with me, than to be used as you use your dog?
Tempt not too much the hatred of my spirit. I am sick when I do look on thee.
And I am sick when I look not on you.
Oh, you do impeach your modesty too much. Leave the city and commit yourself into the hands of one that loves you not. Trust the opportunity of night and the ill counsel of a desert place with the rich word of your virginity.
Your virtue is my privilege, for that it is not night when I do see your face. Therefore I think I am not in the light. Nor doth this with that world of company. For you, in my respect, are all the world. And how can it be said I am alone? When all the world's here to look on me.
I'll run from thee and hide me in the brakes. I'll lead thee to the mercy of wild beasts.
wildest hath not such a heart as you. Run when you will, the story shall be changed. Apollo flies and Daphne holds the chase. The dove pursues the griffin, the mild hide. Make speed to catch the tiger. Bootless speed, when cowardice pursues and valor flies.
Ah, I will not stay thy questions, let me go.
Or if thou follow me, do not believe, but I shall do thee mischief in this wood.
I, in the temple in the town of Neil, you do me mischief, fie Demetrius. Your roles do set a scandal on my sex. We cannot fight for love as men we do. We should be wooed and we're not made to woo. I'll follow thee and make heaven and hell, to die upon the hand I love so well.
Fare thee well, then. If he believe this rope, thou shalt fly him. We shall seek thy love. Welcome, hand down the liquor there.
Aye, there it is.
Pray thee, give it me. I know a bank where the wild thyme blows, but ox lips and nodding violet blows. White of the canopy by luscious woodbine, there sleeps the tiniest under the night. With this juice, let's streak her eyes and make her full of paper fantasies. Next thing then, she waking looks upon shall dote. The greatest extremity. Take thou some of it. Seek a sweet Athenian lady is in love. With a disdainful youth, anoint his eyes. Do it when the next thing he espies may be the lady. Shall know the man by the Athenian garments he hath on.
Fear not, my lord, your servant shall be.